Hi, and welcome to yet another new Azure Vlog episode. In this one, I will talk about software development. Software development explained for the IT pro. Nowadays, infrastructure as a code is getting more and more popular. Last week, I was in an event, a Dutch event, that was called Experts Live Café. And one of the topics was infrastructure as a code. And the main message was that you have to thread the resources in the cloud in your data center, just like you are doing software development. Back in the old days, I was a software developer myself. So I will try to explain the process to you. But first, let's start with some impressions of Experts Live Café. So before I explain you software development, let's first talk about Experts Live. Later on this year, they are going to host a big event in the Netherlands. 1200 people will attend to that event. And they are currently looking for some nice speakers. So if you are that enthusiastic speaker, and you have a nice session, just go to the link that I've put in the description, which is the call for speakers. Submit your talk. And maybe we'll meet each other at the Experts Live later on this year. I already submitted 3 talks, so fill in the form and you're ready to go. So now let's talk about software development. Software development is not that complicated as many of us think. I will try to explain this to you in this vlog. So let's start with the first step. The first step is actually writing the code. Software developers write code. And you, as an IT pro, when you're going to work with a cloud environment, you're probably also going to write some code. And no, that's not scary. Actually, it's quite funny. When I started writing code, I immediately saw how it can make my life more easy. I actually hate all those recurring things that we have to do, like deploying virtual machine, deploying users in an Active Directory. So I scripted them out. Writing code for automation is actually the same as writing code for software. What software developers most likely do when they finished writing their code is put the code in a version control system. And you probably have heard of Git, Visual Studio Team Services, Bitbucket, or some other version control system. Those systems allow software developers to save code in a repository. What's the interesting thing about this is that the version control systems keep track on the changes that are made to a file. So first I do my initial commit, and then I do some small changes which will make my script more efficient. I also save my new edited script in the version control system. And when I look in my version control system, I can see the changes. I can see the difference between my initial commit, the first script, and the version that I just committed. Once the code or the script is in the version control system, most of the time the CI/CD pipelines will kick off. CI stands for continuous integration and CD stands for continuous deployment. CI/CD is actually a process. And one of the first things that are executed in that process is the build. The build actually compiles the code, package the code, it does some unit tests and save our package or the output of the build in a drop location. So let's go through the things I just mentioned. When a software developer is writing his code, you actually can't do anything with it. The code is just a file. That file then goes through what's called a compiler. And the compiler interprets the text that's in that file and creates the application of it. So this is the thing that translates your code into a working application. So now let's talk about unit tests. What are unit tests? Unit tests are the smallest pieces of tests that are getting executed to the code. In the code, we mainly write functions or small procedures, and we can test them. We can actually, when we write a function, we have input, input parameters, and we have output. And what a unit test is actually doing, it puts some values in the function and it checks if the output is what you would expect when you input those values earlier in the function. So the smallest piece of test that is possible during the software development process. I also mentioned packaging, and I guess you already know what a package is. So when you look at the output of the compiler, you have a .exe file and some couple of DLL files, etc. And what you do in the packaging step is mainly package those files together and make an installer from it, or another kind of deployment package which you can apply to your environment. One interesting thing about the packages is that you assign a version number to them. So this is where your version number comes from. We have a code that's in a repository, that code gets compiled. We have lots of files, we package them together and assign a version number to them. The next thing is that we are going to do DTEP, development, test, acceptance, production. We have a couple of stages which the package is going through. First, it gets deployed to the development stage. And this is actually the stage on which the developer can verify if the code he earlier created works. After the developer has agreed that everything is working great on the development environment, the application gets deployed in a test environment. And in this test environment, most likely, testers are going to have a look at the application, compare the application with a functional design that's created earlier, and test if the application works like described in the functional design. If the tester agreed that the application is working as described in the functional design and there are no bugs found, then the application gets deployed in the acceptance environment. And this is the environment where most likely the customer or product owner is going to have a look at the product. He checks if the things that he had in thought are actually implemented as he would it to be. And if he agrees, well, then we can deploy the application in production. So that's actually mainly CI/CD. So now let's have a look how we can apply this process to infrastructure as a code. When we have a look at the code we are producing as IT pros, mainly scripts, some ARM templates, bash files, etc. Those things are actually software code. And we can treat them as the same way. So we can save them in a version control system like Git, like Bitbucket, like Visual Studio Team Services, etc. And apply versioning to them. By doing that, you track all changes that you apply to your file. The next step, doing a build, is also possible for our scripts. We can package them. We don't have to compile them, but we can package them and assign a version number to them. And the next thing, deploying our assets to a development environment, also applies to us. We, as IT pros, are the developers of those scripts, ARM templates, bash files, etc. We have to test them. So in the test environment, we roll them out. And we test if everything that we did in our template is over there. And then we have the test version. Most of the time when you design your template, you have some requirements. You're not going to build a template out of nothing. There are some requirements. There are some things that need to be in there. In this step, you can validate if the things you wanted in there are actually in there. And then we have the acceptance stage. Imagine you're already running a script in production and it's a script that's execute quite times per day, and you want to replace your script in production for the newly created one. Most of the time you're not gonna do that directly in production. You're first gonna do that in the acceptance stage. If something goes wrong, only your acceptance environment is crashed and not your production environment. So you can use that to check how your scripts, templates, bash files, etc. are working in a production-like environment. If they're working okay there, well, then deploy them in your production stage. And with that, I would like to end this Azure vlog. I hope you found this interesting. I hope this explains a lot to you. If not, please feel free to comment and I will try to answer all your questions. So, if you like this one, please hit the thumbs up button. Also, subscribe to this channel. If you subscribe to this channel, you get a notification automatically when I upload new videos. And of course, see you in the next one. Bye-bye.